Good morning, dear students, and welcome to our next chapter in science, which is Introduction to Acids and Bases. Students, we eat different types of food on a daily basis, and we use different types of ingredients to prepare our food items. Now, do all our food items taste exactly the same? Well, absolutely not. Our food items can be spicy or sweet, sour or bitter, or even bland. Now, what is it that gives food its particular taste? It's of course the different ingredients we use in our food. Lemon, tamarind, tomato, vinegar, all these food items make our food sour. Karela, coffee, ginger make our food bitter. Sugar and jaggery makes our food sweet. Chilies make our food spicy. Not adding salt to our food makes it bland. So we can easily say that we are surrounded by foodstuffs that gives us particular taste when we use it in our food. But how is it that a particular taste is obtained? It is due to special compounds which are present in our foodstuff. So in our today's chapter, we will be concentrating on two of these main compounds, which are acids and bases, and learn in more detail about them. Now, lemon, tamarind, vinegar, amla, curd, all these items are substances that have a sour taste due to the presence of a typical compound in them, which is called as acids. Now, acids are soluble in nature, which means that they can get mixed completely with water. But acids are also corrosive in nature. That is, it can cause harmful effects. Animals and plants also possess acids. In human beings also, there is acid present. Now, you will say where? Well, acid is present in our stomach, which is a diluted form of hydrochloric acid. And it is this acid that helps in the process of digestion of our food. Now, acids that are obtained from foodstuffs are called natural acids or carbonic acids. These acids are weak in nature, which means when we eat such foods, we will not die. So such acids are called as weak acids. However, some acids are strong in nature and they are called strong acids or mineral acids. For examples, sulfuric acid, concentrated hydrochloric acid, nitric acid. If concentrated solution of these acids fall on our body, it can burn the skin. Also, if the vapors of this are taken in or if they are inhaled, it can cause harm to the health. Now let us have a look at the next type of compound, which is base. Base is also called as alkali. If you have ever tasted soap when you are having a bath, you will find that it is slightly bitter in taste. Now, such substances which have a bitter taste, or which is also called as an astringent taste, and are slippery in touch, are called as bases or alkali. Examples are baking soda, caustic soda, milk of magnesia, soap, washing powder, etc. Bases are completely different from acids. If I have to tell you in a shortcut, I can easily say that acids and bases have properties that are completely opposite to each other. Now, if we have a look at this particular slide, we see that the substances which are present on the left hand side are all acidic in nature. Battery, the acid present in our stomach, lemon, vinegar, tomato, coffee, milk. these are all acidic in nature. And the names which are present on the right hand side are all basic in nature, like the drain cleaner, bleach, soap, ammonia solution, stomach tablets. Stomach tablets means something like Eno or Digene, baking soda, and blood. All these substances are basic in nature. But in the middle, we have water. Now, we all know that water is tasteless. It does not have a taste. So, we can say that water is neither acidic nor basic. Water is neutral in nature. Now, in the next slide, we will understand what is the difference between acids and bases or alkaline. Now, an acid is a chemical substance which is having a pH value below 7. An alkali is also a chemical solution which has a pH value above 7. Aqueous solutions of acids are composed of H ion, hydrogen ions. That is, if we mix acid with water, we get hydrogen ions. Aqueous solutions of alkali are made up of OH ions. That is, when we mix an alkali with water, we get OH ions, which is hydroxide ions. The taste of an acid is sour, whereas the taste of an alkali is bitter. Acids are sticky in nature and alkali are slippery in nature. And finally, acids can be neutralized by bases, and bases or alkali can be neutralized by acids. Next, let us understand what is an indicator. An indicator is a substance which is neither acidic or basic. It is a neutral substance. Certain substances are used as indicators to recognize if there are acids or bases present around us. Now, an indicator will change its color in the presence of an acid or a base. Some of the most commonly used acids in laboratories are methyl orange, methyl red, phenolphthalein, and litmus paper. If you look at the first picture on the top left hand side, in the bottle there is the indicator methyl orange, which is orange in color. Now, when this methyl orange is put into an acid, it will change the color of the solution to pink. And when methyl orange is put into a base, the entire liquid will turn yellow. Now, in the second picture on the top right hand side, in the bottle, the indicator present is called as phenolphthalein, which is colorless. But when phenolphthalein is put into an acid, it will continue to remain colorless. It will not change its color. But on the other hand, when we put phenolphthalein into a base, it will make the entire solution pink in color. Now, in the third picture on the bottom, we see that when a blue litmus paper is dipped into an acid, the paper turns red. And when a red litmus paper is dipped into a base, the paper turns blue. These indicators are what we used in chemical laboratories. But apart from these, we also have some domestic indicators which are naturally available. For example, turmeric or haldi. You must have noticed that after eating food, when we wash our plates with soap, if there is haldi stain on the plate, then that stain will automatically turn reddish in color. So, we can understand over here that turmeric is a type of a natural
indicator. Next, let us have a look at the different sources of acid. Vinegar contains an acid called as acetic acid. Lemon contains citric acid. Tomatoes contain oxalic acid. Grapes and tamarind contains tartaric acid. Curds, milk contains lactic acid. Apples contain malic acid. And ants, if you have ever been bitten by ants, you know that when the ant bites you, you feel a little burning sensation. That is because ants contain formic acid. When they bite you, they insert that formic acid into your skin along with the bite. So that is why when that formic acid enters into our skin, we feel the burning sensation for some time. Now, all these sources of acid are all weak acids because they are all natural acids. Next, let us understand the different uses of acids. Acids are used in the production of certain chemical fertilizers. Certain plants require the soil to be slightly acidic in nature. So that is when these acids are used as chemical fertilizers. Now, acids are also used in the production of explosives, for the purification of oil, for the preparation of certain medicines and dyes and paints. Hydrochloric acid is used for the preparation of different types of chloride salts. Dilute sulfuric acid is used in batteries that we use in our vehicles. Then dilute hydrochloric acid is used for the sterilization of water, for making the water sterile. And finally, acids are also used in making white paper from wood pulp. If we directly use the wood pulp to make paper, then that paper is slightly creamish or yellowish in color. But when acids are used or mixed with that wood pulp, then it gives the pure white color to the paper. Next, let us understand the uses of alkali or the uses of bases. Alkali or bases are used to neutralize acid. For example, magnesium hydroxide is used in medicines whenever we have any acidity problem or any indigestion problem due to high acidity. Then we have certain medicines which contain magnesium hydroxide or even aluminium hydroxide. These help in neutralizing the excessive acid in our stomach. Alkalis are used for washing. Certain substances like calcium hydroxide is used in toothpaste, soaps, dish detergents, washing powders for our clothes, washing materials for our vessels. So all these contain the alkali calcium hydroxide. Alkalis are used in medicines and also for the production of fertilizers which are alkali in nature or which are basic in nature. For example, ammonium hydroxide. Now, certain plants require basic soil. They require the soil to be alkaline in nature. So for those plants, we use fertilizers which contain alkali or which contain bases. Now we come to the last part of our chapter, which is neutralization. Now, what is neutralization? It is a very simple process. When an acid and a base are mixed together, then a chemical reaction takes place between them and we get a salt which is produced and water which is produced. This type of reaction is called as a neutralization reaction. So with this, dear students, we come to the end of this chapter. So till we meet again, stay safe, stay happy. Bye.